Good evening friends, this is Jagdish Ahuja, your teacher, trainer, transformer, and today I'm going to be asking you a question. Can you have the cake and eat it too? Is it possible for you to take delivery and be paid for it? I mean, it sounds ridiculous, right? But that's exactly what happened yesterday on the Chicago Mercantile Stock Exchange to crude. And the WTI crude, the West Texas Intermediate as it's popularly known as, of crude, started at week at $18 a barrel. And that was the last day of the settlement. That means, you know, at the end of that, everything, whoever is left with open positions must take delivery. And then what happens? Towards the close, the buyers panic because they realized one thing, they could not take the delivery. And I'll come to the reason later, but the sellers were pressing for delivery and saying, you know, were not willing to buy back. And as a result, the buyers panicked and they, you know, kept selling and paying minus $40, you know, dollars to a barrel as penalty just to, you know, close the contract. So what was the reason behind such a freak, a literally flash crash in crude yesterday? There were only two reasons. The first reason, of course, is the corona pandemic, which is worldwide, and that's caused a huge demand shock. And what do we mean by demand shock? The demand has come down drastically because everybody is staying indoors, nobody is moving around. And as a result, industries are, you know, partly closed. People are not, commuting, no travel, no tourism, no nothing is happening. So as a result, what is the reason? I mean, this is the reason, you know, there was a demand shock. So crude is not being consumed. And on the other side, the storage facilities are getting fuller. So the storage facilities, you know, the delivery of this WTI crude is done from a place called Cushing in Oklahoma. And it was almost at 75-80% capacity and could not take this delivery at all. As a result, the buyers panicked because there was no way they could have taken delivery of this crude, and they came out selling. So what does this imply in the long run for crude? The answer is, this is a bad sign. This is a bad sign that the world economy has slowed to such an extent that even after, you know, Trump having a mediation between Russia and Saudi Arabia, and the OPEC nations are agreeing for deep cuts and trying to hold the price, they were not able to do that. So as a result, you know, they have agreed for cuts, and in spite of the cuts, this has happened. So the bottom of crude is literally gone, and it literally has to be tested again, you know, in terms of that crude can go to newer lows as long as this pandemic continues, because that's how severe it is. What does it also mean? It also means another thing, the warning bell for the economies who are oil rich and who are depending only on oil. There, that's where the problem is, because now what can happen is, because of this, there could be geopolitical tensions, because of this, you know, there could be instability, etc., etc. So everybody's plans have gone awry. For example, Saudi Arabia has based its budget on crude being at $80, and today, as I'm talking to you, it's $18 a barrel. Now imagine, where's your budget and where are you, and how will you be able to sustain, and for how long? So the key to this entire oil shock is only one thing: how long the pandemic lasts, how long are we locked down, or the world is locked down. And as long as the world is locked down, crude is going to be under pressure, and it will lead to more tensions among countries. It's going to lead to more catastrophes among the financial community. Yesterday we heard that, you know, there was some oil trade which has gone wrong, which was funded by ICICI in Singapore. That again caused the stock to fall 8%. So we, you know, these sort of ramifications are going to be all along. And definitely, you know, what we can see, two things from this. One, that the world has reached saturation in terms of storage. Second, the world is absolutely having an oversupply of crude as of now. So with this, let's see how the future beholds. But yes, as of now, crude is, you know, back at $18 a barrel, and it's not at negative as what people think, you know, that is crude going to be negative. So the June futures contracts, which I've already traded, are close to, you know, $18 right now. So this was what I wanted to say. Over and out. Take care. Bye-bye. Thank you.